Maryland Ultimate is a lifestyle, a brotherhood. Every year, we set a goal to reach nationals. For 22 years, we've come short. 22 years. 22 different rosters. 22 years worth of friendships, hard-fought victories, and painful losses.
Come on, this way, yeah, 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 yeah. time, Derek. Yes, yes. Let's go, Skeet. Derek. Bigsy. Oh,
keep your
we've been hearing so much shit for so long.
and all the alumni. We're still getting fucking alumni that I had never played with before. And I know that for Isaac, he's just one of the best bastards I've ever played with. And he like epitomizes what it means to beat. And he fucking scores the game-winning goal to go to Nationals. We're fucking going to the dance.
Fucking high. Oh! Oh,
man.
I'm so proud of that effort. I'm so proud of this team. And I couldn't think of any group of people that I'd rather do it with. That is amazing.
That was the perfect ending to the perfect game in what is not the end of our perfect season.
Oh.
We have practice on Tuesday!
Let's warm up. We've done all the work. We've put in the work. We're ready. Now comes the fun part. Let's do it. It's going to be fun.
And we're going to talk strategy for just a couple minutes here. Then we're going to warm up. We're going to go through our normal routine, do warm ups, do progressions. Then we're going to move over to our actual field to take a few minutes. And we'll just do a few minutes of red zone at that point, and then we'll be ready to go. I think all of you guys are aware of the magnitude of what we have the chance to do right now, so I don't think I need to dwell on that. Special group of guys. This team will never take the field again after this weekend. It's your last shot to do something really special. It's already been a great year. Everything's cherry on the top from here, and we're just gonna try to play the best ultimate we possibly can. And when we're at our peak, when we're at that level, we can hang with anyone, we can win any game. All right, strategically, Illinois has had kind of an interesting path to get here. They won their region, but they did not beat the best team in their region. Michigan got knocked off in the semis by Notre Dame. So they're riding a long winning streak. We know how dangerous that is. We know how we felt coming through, going undefeated Sunday, Easterns, undefeated sectionals, all the way through. So they're dangerous, but that also puts a lot of pressure on them because they probably haven't been down in quite some time. So anything we can do to unsettle them, to give them that feeling that, oh right, we're at Nationals, we're the 5G, anything we can do to put pressure on them is definitely a good thing to try to get them to fold. The stakes are very high on both sides for this game. We can win our individual man-to-man matchup. I think that's our bread and butter to win this game.
I think we have the athleticism over Illinois, so I think we can really pressure the unders like we did against an Auburn or something like that and make them beat us on perfect deep throws. So I think we should make them grind every cutout, but I think we're right there with them.
Yeah. Can't get discouraged if they get a couple of, you know, jump balls and catch that over us. We just expect that some of those are going to end up falling.
All right, this next hour we're focusing on us. We need to be ready to come out hard. All right, let's go warm up.
So our first game here is against Illinois. Illinois is a very talented team. They took the Great Lakes Regionals. They were the champions for that. And they run a horizontal stack, really strong players, a lot of deep receivers, and so we're really going to have to try to shut down their underneath game and their reset game. I think that if we put a lot of pressure on their handlers, I think that we're going to have some success. It's kind of interesting. We had 7 of our guys graduate yesterday and flew in after midnight, so the team is still kind of getting themselves together. It's a little bit out of our usual routine because we haven't had our normal practices for a couple of weeks. In life and in ultimate, there are things that we can control and there are things that we can't control. Our pool matchups are one of those things that's totally beyond our control. However, what we can do is we can control how we prepare, we can control how we play, and we're just going to make the most of the opportunity that we have, and we know that we'll need to play our very best in order to get any wins in this pool.
Hell yes.
Let's win this thing.
Hell yes.
Yeah. Cherry on the top.
Every game.
This right here was my best case scenario 9 months ago as we first started doing our practices, right? We started looking at those freshmen coming in, looking at our future baby rookies, trying to figure out what they were going to do for us, looking at our returners, figuring out who's going to step up, looking at our seniors, trying to figure out what kind of a statement they were going to make on their way out the door. This is absolutely the best way that we could end this season right here. We've earned it all, right? We've earned our right to be here, earned our own strength bid, bought our own ticket. It's time to enjoy it. And there is nothing better than playing Ultimate Well with your close friends, with your brothers, at Nationals, on a beautiful sunny day in Wisconsin, right? We know it's not all gonna go exactly how we want it to. It never does, right? Never. When it starts to go wrong though, we're gonna make a course correction. We're gonna lift each other up. We're gonna take care of our business. We're gonna take our personal responsibility and do everything we can within our power to right that ship, all right? We don't know how it's going to go. That's why it's so much fun, right? We don't know how the games are going to end. But there's some stuff that we can control, and we can actually make a difference for this team and keep this party going for as long as possible. All right, let's have fun. Let's get some breaks.
Absolutely.
Foot on the pedal, boys. This is it. This is all we got.
Hey, I've got a big goal for this weekend. Score the first point. That's my goal.
Boys, make it plays! Forward! Hey, one more, let's go! Feet, behind you!
Best on three!
1, 2, 3!
Busters!
lot of hucks that we just kind of like want to get it a little too far. It's sitting flat and going out the back of the end zone. Those are things that like we've played, we've all played for at least a year now, some of us a lot longer than that. We know what, how to play. I think we got to like turn our brain off and let our body take over. We deserve to be here.
We're doing a lot of thinking, and we all know how to play this game. We don't need to think while we play, right? Should be all in the back of your head. You know how to do this, right? Just get in that rhythm and just go. But you don't need to think about those throws. You don't need to think about those catches. The second you do, that's when you, you know, win it.
So I think when it comes down to it, when I look back at that game, there's two things that stick out to me. First, they had just a little bit more hustle than us. We were playing hard, we were getting pieces, but when there were opportunities, they were quick to leap on them, and we were just a little bit slower to come across and make a play. We've got to have a certain fearlessness when we're out there. I know there's a lot of things on our mind, but when it comes down to it, we've just got to find a way to get to the disc first. I mean, that's really what this is about, right? Offense, defense, whatever. When that disc is in the air, we just have to be the first one there and make things happen. Mm-hmm. Up until that disc was in the air, I was satisfied with 95% of what we did, offense or defense. But at the end, they were the ones that made the plays, and we did it. So that's one thing that stuck out to me. Some of that's luck, some of that's hustle, whatever you want to call it, we need to find a way to tap in and get more of it. The second thing that stands out is, were we able to make the most of our opportunities? We had chances to score. Whether it's our D-line forced a turnover, we had a shot at it. Whether our O-line got the disc back, we had a second shot at it. How would we rate the value of the looks that we got and where we took it? We had some miscommunication. We had some turns on dump passes or up the lines. We had some aggressively lasery hucks, some out-of-bound hucks. A lot of forcing it up that sideline right over there in those 2 yards. Is that the absolute most that we can make of the few opportunities that we get here? I would argue it's not. I think we can do more with it. I think this is a team that can make more of it when we get those chances. And if we do that, we absolutely can win 2 of our next 3, find a win for players.
One, 2, 3,
Maryland!
We just weren't quite there. We weren't playing loose. We looked like we were thinking too much out there. I think the second half, we started to show that fire. I know our D-line got an incredible break. They probably held the disc for about 3 minutes, finally punched it in on an inside break to the close end zone. That fired us up. I think that took us to tied or down one. And then they ended up pulling away, getting a couple breaks. Ended up losing 15-13. It's pretty disappointing, but we got a couple more games to play, and if we come out like we know we can, we're going to take a couple games in this pool.
Not the roll call 2015 disc. Not this. Daddy!
Holy crap.
No! Base, fucking bastards.
Holy shit. That's so cool, Josh.
We'll figure out how to hang this on the 10.
We're going white. We are on offense up there.
Yeah, baby.
All right? Got this game off right. Hey, we got nothing to be tight about, right?
Yeah.
We're going out. I don't care what the name says on the front of these jerseys. We're playing hard. We're playing the way we know we can. Let's do it. Let's make something happen.
Hey, coming out, we got Nate Davidson. We got Garrett.
Yeah, Garrett.
Tim.
Yeah, Tim.
We got Swift.
Yeah, Swift.
We got Krabby.
Yeah, Krabby.
We got Liam.
Yeah, Liam.
Hey, Garrett. Aaron.
Let them know who's coming. Basketball 3. 1, 2, 3.
Basketball! Johnny, yeah, Johnny. Yes.
It's over.
Fresh, clean slate, 0-0. We're gonna be coming out on D-line, going upwind. Have that desperation to get that upwind break.
Yeah.
We need this break. Can't be complacent. We have to find a way to extend it. 0-0, that's all you should be thinking about. My goal for this weekend, score the next point.
You're looking great.
Yeah, baby.
Hey, keep grinding on those cuts. These guys, you don't have the legs to run with us.
Listen, if you're open, if your guy's coaching you, tell the reset to get out of there and you be the guy that comes back. Doesn't matter if it's Davidson, doesn't matter if it's Garrett. If you are completely uncovered, we'd rather have a completely uncovered guy getting it in that open space. And so tell them to push and you come across and get back.
That's
just
for us. Bastards.
Hey.
Once this weekend. That's a plateau for one of our finest of the year.
I do declare.
Hey, all I have is okay.
That's all right. Damn.
What do you say? Oh!
Tim just.
Timmer.
Where are you? Grass.
Yes, Tim!
Tim, are you invisible?
I'll pack my camo tomorrow.
No.
Shit. And that's the defensive intensity, right? Yeah. We're missing that in the Illinois game. We weren't hustling to those 50-50s, but we did it here. And it pays off, right? We got those D's and we turned them into breaks. That's awesome.
We can beat anybody.
Yeah, we can play with anybody here.
There wasn't one time where the disc went up in that game and I thought, man, Maryland doesn't have a play on that. We're contesting everything, that's great. That's the intensity we need tomorrow.
Yep.
All right, so obviously we had a rough start to the day. Played Illinois in the morning. Didn't come out as strong as we wanted, offensively and defensively. So, lost that game, which was a little disappointing. Definitely had the potential to be a rough day, but had the opportunity to play Oregon, who we've played before, had a close game with them at Easterns, and we all came out pretty amped for that game, knowing that it was make or break, kind of keep us in this weekend, and came out strong, defensive intensity was a lot higher, got a few Ds, turned them into breaks, ended up holding on, winning 15-11, which was a huge win, one of the biggest wins we've had in Maryland history, which was sweet. So going into tomorrow, 1-1, kind of middle of the pack in our pool, got two huge games playing the 1-2 season in our pool, UNC and FSU. I'm extremely excited. Just, I know our team especially comes out strong against better teams. Just knowing that we're going to get a chance at both of those teams is awesome. And all we need to do is win one game to make it to Sunday. So I think we've got a good shot at beating one of those guys. And I know we're going to come out strong. And regardless, they're going to be fun games to play just because it's going to be high quality.
Them to switch, if we force this wall to crash down and pick people up, there's going to be bigger gaps over the top. And we can't be afraid to take that over the top throw if that's a throw that's in your arsenal and if there's an available receiver.
Alright, so this day is all about us. We've got a chance to win our pool today, right? We take care of business. This pool is ours. Get it done.
And we are wearing white, coming out on offense. Coming out, Nate.
Davidson.
Swift.
Yes, Swift.
Tim.
Yes, Tim.
Krabby.
Yes, Krabby.
Biggs.
Yeah, Biggs.
Johnny.
Yeah, Johnny.
Saturday,
we're still playing, baby.
Still playing
to win the pool.
All right, the battle is played. Bastards on three.
1, 2, 3, Bastards!
Oh,
Chill, Tim. Chill, Tim. Or fuck it. Daisy.
Run him down, baby. Run him down, seven.
So that's a game of almost, right? We had a lot of chances. We're outside, ready to break probably 6-7 times just in that second half alone. A couple more in that first half. Just a matter of, like, you know, inches, little throws, little things. We cleaned it up, we're doing well. At the same token, all we can ask for right now is a chance to control our own destiny, and we have that, right? We have one game, it's pretty simple. We win this game, we're through. We get another chance to play together as Maryland Ultimate 2015.
This could very well be the last day we play together, right? I don't want that. I want to keep playing with this team. I want this to be the last day, man.
Look at that smile.
I want to keep this ride going. All right, we got to dig deep.
Hey, I'm proud of you guys. That was a tough game. We didn't get any breaks until I think they had 13.
Yeah.
Came up with the matching pair right there at the end. Had some chances. Tail end of that second half, we did finish strong. We didn't win, but we finished strong, for sure. Proud of you guys. You played well. Strong team, good team, a team that might be playing on Monday. We got one more chance. It's Florida State. I believe we control our own destiny. If we win that, we're in the future.
So that game against North Carolina, it's kind of a game of, like, you know, like this close, you know. There's a lot of things that are, you know, we just didn't connect on a few things, had some drops, had some D's we could have got, but, like, you know, we didn't go as hard. Pretty close, but overall, I really like how the second half went more than the first. Second half, we definitely had that confidence back, had that, like, fearlessness that kind of defined our season so far, you know, throughout Easterns, throughout sectionals and regionals. When we play our best, we don't really care who we're playing. It's all about us and, you know, having that confidence, that swagger to play with the best, and we don't care who you are. We don't care what your pedigree is. We're going to play our game and have fun doing it. And in the first half, we weren't quite there. Second half definitely brought that back. I think if we can put together a complete game like that second half, going forward against Florida State, we'll be in a good position.
Legs turning, all right, leaving it all on the ground here. I know it's gonna be a shitty sensation if we're sitting on the sidelines later and they're playing a game. It's us or them right now. Do or die. I want to be playing later. I want to play more with you guys. I'm not done.
Yeah.
All right? We are not done. This is our game to win. Let's go out and fucking earn it.
Hell yeah, boys. Come on, Mike. Come on, Mike.
Hey, sidelines got to be loud. Yeah. Talking to everybody.
Challenge.
Balls to balls, please.
Maryland on three.
Loud and proud.
1, 2, 3.
Maryland!
Hey guys, hey!
Something's new but nothing's changed.
Yes, please, please. Here! Please catch it!
He wants a crabby, he wants a crabby!
Shooter! Shooter! Up! Up! Up!
Stay there!
Go!
Go! Run! Steven, run!
Not everyone, you guys! Get there, get there!
Oh no!
The goal of this game, the second half, really the Nationals as a whole for me, was proving to ourselves that we are every bit as good as any team here. And I think we all kind of knew that coming in. And this half, this cool play, we validated it. Didn't quite get the results we wanted as a whole, but each individual point, each individual game, and every player really, I think, played exceptionally well. So good. I'm proud. I'm proud. We can keep our heads up.
Yeah. I mean, we came here to battle, right? And battle against great teams, and we did that. And they said we proved that we can compete with anybody here. And we did just that. And it's going to sting for a little bit, and it should. But, I mean, we should walk out of this tournament heads held high, right? Prove that we were just as good as anybody. Cards didn't necessarily fall the way they could have. I know for a fact we're better than some teams that are going to play tomorrow. But that's just the way it is. And what we got is to play three outstanding teams. Three teams that were in the top 10 of the country all year long. And hey, we got a win. Maybe the best win in Maryland history here at Nationals. And that's awesome. I mean, we won a game at Nationals against fucking Oregon, right? Yeah. That's awesome. Heads up, be proud of that, all right?
Yeah. This is the furthest that Maryland's ever gone. I've talked to some of the alumni years past, teams that have been in games to go against Pitt for the regionals. They have said, without a doubt, this Maryland team would wipe all the other Maryland teams that have ever existed. This is the best team that we've ever had. You guys to be down on yourselves right now, it's, you know, we just lost a game, but realize that you are the best team that Maryland's ever had. Wear that with pride, okay? Be happy with what we've accomplished this year. No one has ever accomplished that before.
So proud of this team. You guys left it all out there through these four games. I told you at the start of the year, every season, except for one, ends on a loss, right? At some point, everybody gets knocked out of contention except the national champion. That being said, in about a half hour here, we have the chance to end our season on a win at Nationals, which is sweet. Sometimes you get the chance to keep playing, and sometimes it's your last shot. At the time, you have no idea. So this could be your last shot to take down a team, win a game at Nationals, win another game at Nationals. Whether it's 5 o'clock, whether it's 8:30, whatever it is, we are going to go and do our absolute best to try to end the season on a win.
I mean, personally, I don't really want to say anything negative right now. Right, focus on the positives, right? I mean, this is an amazing tournament, an amazing experience. I had a ton of fun, right? First time in Maryland history, and it's been a goal of mine, I know most of ours since you started here at Maryland, to get to Nationals, right? We earned that, right? And nobody can take that away from us. We earned this, we got here, we proved that we can compete with any team here. And honestly, I'm gonna walk away from this with my head held high, proud of everything that we did as a team. I mean, thank you guys. This is amazing. This is a fucking great season.
Yeah. All right, I got a little something I want to do. We got an MVP jersey here. All right,
Take a look at this. It's from Savage.
It actually says MVP.
It actually says MVP. And so I want to give this out to somebody who this year has stepped up. He was new, all right? And he stepped up and he made himself part of the family on and off the field. Tim.
Oh, yeah.
Trade you.
Yeah, now go get another Cubs jersey.
Last year really sucked. I didn't really enjoy, like, I don't know, playing as a senior on my team and not making D3 Nationals. And, you know, just coming in as a new player and having you guys accept me and, you know, just welcome me as part of the team has been really awesome. I'm so happy that I got to talk after this with you guys. It's a real fun tournament. Thanks, guys.
Two alumni messaged me, Tommy Longballs and Travis. And they wanted to just send the message that they were super proud of us this weekend and that this was a goal of theirs, you know, 5-6 years ago. It didn't happen, but they were kind of living their dream through us, and they just wanted to let everyone know that they were super proud of us, and keep that in the back of your minds too.
Yeah, I want to echo what Big said. I mean, obviously we hope to have a different outcome this morning, but when we reflect back on this, from, you know, like half an hour from now through the rest of our lives, we're not gonna think about the consolation bracket game against Western Washington. It didn't mean anything. We're gonna think about that Oregon win. We're gonna think about that triple break that we had on Florida State when we were coming back, just rolling against them, grabbing Callahan's, that kind of stuff.
Yeah, like,
when we think about the tournament, the not so good parts, they're gonna fade away, right? They're gonna fade in the background, and it sucks now, sure, but that stuff, you're not gonna remember it. It's that good stuff, the really sweet stuff. 12-hour Milwaukee car drive, Sam. It's that kind of stuff that's gonna stick. So I understand there's probably, I'm already seeing some more smiles coming out right now, which is great. So treasure those best parts, and forget about the rest. The rest doesn't matter. Just remember what we did. Love you guys. It's been a special year.
Yeah, why not? Go. Here. Shit.
You know, it's just awesome to wear the Maryland on your chest and represent your team and your friends and honestly your teammates. So it really shows, you know, how special this team really is, and just to end your season at Nationals, it's just a really awesome time, and to represent all those alumni before us, it's a great experience.
Or as a couple. Yeah. Or you can go as like two guys, two girls, whatever. And
so you have to group up for this.
You don't need to group up. You can go as a single and look for a double. Or you could use it like Tinder, just for another single. But it gives you the opportunity to go for the double.
So we're talking
double.
So
hey man, nice play it down there.
Yeah, go for it.
Oh my god. Oh my god.